This is my first album, folks. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? 28 years. 28 years. How about that story about what happened in Salt Lake, Andy? Forget it. 28 years. 28 years. You know why? Why rush it? That's what I said. I did a DVD. Let's not kid ourselves. Why would we should be kidding ourselves? Diane says it's gonna be it could be on vinyl if you're one of those people who doesn't want to listen to something. You just want to have it on a shelf. Oh, I love vinyl. You, do you have a record player? No, I just I have vinyl seat covers in my car because I like the frequency response. Wrote that at 11 o'clock this morning. The frequency response of the vinyl seat covers. I like the low bass. 7 hertz. Is anything I'm saying in the booth, is anything right? HDMI, HDMU, more like. At home, I'm jogging on the stage with a hilarious physical comedy that I could do that is available if you actually come out to see me in the show. It took me I've been tweeting for 400 hours to get 2 shows. Look at this, it's all filled. It's all, as far as you can tell, people. It wasn't an empty seat in the house because people had sandwiches on them. Again, I go back to the thing in the hum and the hum and the hang. Boo! I've been tweeting 24 hours a day about this. I can't get 80 people into a room. $5 is prohibitive for the people who enjoy my comedy. I don't know, $5? What do I get with that? Does he walk me to the car and do jokes for $5? What does that come with? So, here's something. So anyway, in Salt Lake City, they kept apologizing why the turnout was bad. They said, I'm sorry. First of all, I've never figured out how to connect material and a theme. I'm never gonna have one of those one-man shows that starts out with, I was always afraid to eat crackers. And then at the end, and then I had a cracker. Boom. I have no theme. We're not going somewhere tonight. It's not about the journey. It's about the journey, me complaining about the journey, me wondering why they call it journey, me doing a journey band joke. Why am I winded? I'm winded from walking back and forth 3 times. I'm like Dan Cook after a hip replacement, which he's gonna have to have. Doctor's gonna say, I can tell by these x-rays. Were you ever overselling your punchlines at any point in your career? Seems like. I see. Did you ever use too much hair product because your upper spine is changed? Dan Cook was unable to secure an audition for the show Person of Interest. Woo! A joke that requires you to know about the show Person of Interest. I've never been able to connect material in a thematic way, and I've never come up with the best segue I ever came up with was, speaking of jokes, on the subject of humor, I always do the second example of that. People have pointed out that the first one's fine. You can't stop me. I'm Mr. I do what I want and I don't go, I'm taking my career to another part of the same level. That's what I'm doing. I don't want ups and downs. You get hot, then people, when you get cold, people go, oh, remember when he was hot? But if you never get hot, huh? Huh? Who's thinking now? My autobiography is gonna be called Below the Radar, the Andy Kendall story. That's what it's gonna be called. That's me when you know I don't know where I'm going. I have ADD. It's serious, it's not a joke. I have ADD. It could be a joke, but I don't have the focus to write something about it. But my mind goes blank every 10 seconds. Is that a good sign? Shouldn't I have more funny observations about? No, because this is the serious part of the show. There's people have problems. Why is my pee popping? Why is there any extraneous sound? Why do I not sound like a contralto, a singer, a mezzo soprano, a mezzo, thank you. However that person's reacting. Kind of a high pitched, could be collapsing from the laugh. Exactly. Maybe more confident on stage. Maybe that's... How's the level up there, Matt and Ryan? Don't screw me later on. I'm going to go over this with a fine-tooth comb, which won't help. But I'm going to do it anyway. You're going to hear from me. Heads will roll. If I hear a popping pee, that pee is popping, damn it! Why can't they make a microphone that makes it sound in a room? And why am I not in Carnegie Hall? Why is this not Lincoln Center? Why am I not conducting myself in an orchestra fashion? Why do I continue to ask questions that there are no answers for? Why is my demographic 80-year-old people? What's going on here? What happened to me? Where are the hipsters? 95 to 100 years old is the crowd. They don't know that at home, Andy. The kids don't know. Now they're going to turn it off when they find out an older person. Hollywood hates old people. If you're old, forget. Get out of here, they say. You brush your teeth with Murder, She Wrote toothpaste. They don't care about you. You don't buy products. Buy the same Swanson's TV dinner for the last 60 years. My references have to be current. Have I done an actual joke? Look, that's not the point. Anybody can do jokes. You want jokes? I got jokes. Because couldn't he want to see if time could fly, all right? Now look, that was the first joke I ever heard. Why did the man throw the clock out the window? He wanted to see if time. I still don't quite get it. I don't get it. He threw, it's literally flying. Andy, why would you explore the first childhood joke?